guys, so today I'm going to be doing a plan with me in my memory keeping planner. So my happy planner for the week of January 16th to 22nd. And I want to try for the first time to do a plan as I go kind of style of planning, see if it really works out. I did kind of a mock spread and it kind of turned out really, really nicely. So I sort of want to do that in this spread for you guys. But it might take a little while to do it because that style is really lengthy, so I thought I would just do it and have it fast forwarded and also do a voiceover to explain everything. But the kit that I'm going to be using is the Simply Ginger Co. kit that she came out with on the Black Friday weekend, so I don't know that there's actually a name to this kit. And so this kit comes with your headers, and then it comes with your full boxes here, as well as your Aubrey Heart checklist, which I probably won't use in this style of planning. And I have the functional sheet with the icons, heart checklist, core labels, flags, script icons, a build do, and a weekend banner. Here you have your half boxes and your headers, which I'm probably not going to use. I'm going to be using glitter headers. And there's littles, two of the three heart checklists, two appointment labels, sidebar items, and then you have your washi and your washi strips. So without further ado, why don't we just get right into the video? So I started off by removing the pages of my planner so I could white out the bottom where there are the polka dots, because that doesn't actually match the spread. And I just used a random sticker sheet and I just flipped it over, so when I white it out, it doesn't get onto the next page in my happy planner. And I did the exact same thing to the other side of the planner, but you'll see shortly that my white out ran out. So I just did off camera and using some sticker paper to cover the remaining of the polka dots. So here at the start of the planning, I just started with my bottom washi as usual, but I had to trim it off with my craft knife, which I just got from the dollar store, and an Erin Condren ruler, because this is a kit for the Erin Condren vertical, and I'm using Happy Planner. I'm doing the same thing on this side of the planner page, and you can use an Erin Condren full-on kit on Happy Planner. You just have to trim the bottom washi. So you'll see shortly that I'm flipping my planner in half and zooming in so it's easier for you guys to see what I'm doing and, like, you know, see details and stuff like that. I start out with my date cover-ups because this is an undated planner and I just want to make sure that I remember what date it is so I don't, like, plan the wrong day or whatever. And instead of using the headers that came with the kit, I decided to use glitter headers. So you'll see me pull off a whole bunch of glitter headers and they're all from Murdoch Chalks. And I'm sorry if there are some, like, places where there are some spacing here where I'm not doing anything. I'm trying to figure out how to do this plan as I go, and I didn't want to fast forward too much because it's hard for me to explain things on certain spaces if they're fast forwarded too much. Here I just have a half box with a coffee sticker from the kit to mark Coffee Monday. I love doing that. It's just something fun, even though I drink coffee every day. Now I have a quarter box with a meal icon just to mark that I was prepping dinner that night because I was making curry. I want to make sure all the stuff was prepped so I can make food right away when I get home, the actual cooking portion of things. And here I am just putting my laundry stuff down. I do laundry 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And I'm separating the section with a glitter header. Here I'm putting a half box, which I'm using a lot in this kit or in this spread here, to do any of my YouTube filming, kind of uploading kind of things, my videos type things. And all these YouTube kind of filming icons are from Station Stickers. She doesn't sell them anymore. She had them when her shop was still on Etsy. And I'm just using, like, the star or heart asterisk that came with the kit as bullet points. On the bottom there, I am just putting down my meal little thing so I can write down my meal. And I'm just moving things around. You'll see a lot in this video, just so that the spacing and things are correct, because this is, like, kind of my first time doing this plan as I go. And the next day, I start out with a glitter header as well. And then I'm putting this appointment label from Simply Ginger Co. and an icon from Station Stickers to mark that I have a video up that day. And then I put a flag as well as a planner sticker, as you will see, to mark that I was doing my main plan with me for the week, or, like, filming it for you guys and stuff like that. So I want to mark that. And then I put a half box to mark all the editing and exporting I had to do because I was filming a video that day. And then the icon, again, is from Station Stickers. After I did that, I put a glitter header to separate the section. There's no rhyme or reason why I do these things. And then I fill that afterwards with a quarter box. And that quarter box, it is from Sponsored by Coffee, that I'm putting to mark my Instagram. And the Instagram sticker, like I said, again, all my social media kind of stickers I'm using this week is from Station Stickers. I was just trying to figure out if I want to put my full box first or put the Instagram stuff first. I just want to stagger my full boxes. I don't want two full boxes right next to each other. Even in my main planner, I don't like my full boxes next to each other. So I'm just seeing where the best place is to place that quarter label. And on the bottom of the day, of course, I put my meal little things. On to Wednesday, again, I start off with a glitter header. And I put a half box and to mark hump day. And my hump day stickers and all my script icons that I use are from Nicole Hutch Designs. I really like her script icon things. Next, I put an appointment label from Simply Ginger Co. To mark that I have a video uploaded live that day, again, with an icon from Station Stickers. And then I put a glitter header there. Next, I put a half box, which I eventually moved to put a full box first because I don't want all the, like again, say the full boxes right next to each other. And then I put my half box, and of course, my half box is for filming and YouTube related kinds of things. And I'm just putting my heart dots that came with the kit. There I'm putting my laundry things, and this laundry sticker is from Queen Bee Designs. I just like to kind of mix and match all kinds of laundry stickers because I do have laundry stickers from a whole bunch of shops. And then on the bottom I put a quarter label and a vacuum to mark that I was vacuuming my house, even though I don't have a vacuum. I just have one of those portable Dirt Devil things because our vacuum died about 2 months ago, so on Amazon I got one of those portable handheld ones. Next year, I am doing the other half of the week, but I, of course, got to put my day cover ups on first so I know which day is what. And you'll see that I forgot to put the date dots. So after this glitter header, I went ahead and put the date dots. And I'm sorry you are unable to see parts of the planner. I forgot to move it down slightly for you guys for the latter part of the week. And then I'm putting a half box there with a cleaning sticker. The cleaning time sticker is actually from Kina Prints. And I just marked that I was sorting my pantry or part of my kitchen because I bought a whole bunch of containers to sort out some dry goods and stuff like that. Next, I mark that I am doing laundry. I usually only do it 3 times a week, but this week I was doing like blankets. So this day I was doing towels and blankets, and the sticker that I use is from Fox and Cactus, and the quarter label is from Sponsored by Coffee. I just flip back and forth just to make sure I don't have the same color next to each other. And again, I'm using those labels to mark that I have a video uploaded that day, and then separated by a glitter header to cover the existing header there because it doesn't match this kit. Then I put a full box there. Just take up some space. And then I've got this idea from, I think, Soda Pop Studios. You just use a washi strip and then put your payday sticker in the middle there. That looks really, really cute. Payday sticker came with a kit. And on the bottom, I was just trying to fill up some space. So I put a glitter header as well as a strip of washi. And of course, I put my meal sticker on the bottom there. The next 3 days, you're unable to see the top portion really well. I'm very, very sorry. So on the top of the next day, I just put a glitter header, of course. And I put a, actually eventually put a washi strip. I took out what I put of the quarter box. I put a washi strip and I put one of those TGI Friday stickers. It's a script icon that I got from Nicole Hutch Design to mark that same way I did with the payday. Instead, I did with the TGIF. After that, I put a quarter label. I'm trying to figure out which planner sticker to use because I want to mark the Planner Boss Collective sale. And I eventually just use a laptop sticker icon from the kit because, of course, you order stickers on Etsy online, obviously, on your computer. And I put another quarter a label, again, from Sponsored by Coffee, if I didn't mention that. And I just put an alarm clock icon because Simply Ginger Co. had a mystery kit live that day at 8 a.m. in the morning. Want to make sure I wasn't missing out on that. Then I put a full box. And after the full box, I put another half box there to do my uploading and exporting and all these video kinds of things. So with the half box and with the icon from Station Stickers and then the heart dots from the kit. And after that, I put a appointment label from Simply Ginger Co. Just so that I can mark that I was making stir fry that day. And the icon was from Nicole Hutch Designs. I usually don't mark when I make food. It's just that I was making it for the next day because I didn't want to wake up in the morning to make food for lunch on a Saturday morning. So I just decided to make it on Friday night. because I wasn't really making anything extravagant for my dinner that night anyway, so I had time to be able to make the stir fry. It was a Thai basil stir fry for the next day, so that I could have it with my hubby because he likes spicy food a lot. Up next day, I'm sorry you can't really see it, but I just put a glitter header on top, and then I put a to-do header from the kit, and I'm just using one of the 3-heart checklists because I had 3 mundane kind of things to do, and I just didn't know what else to do it. I didn't want to put a full-on ombre heart checklist, and I did one of the things was laundry. I had to do the jackets because my hubby works long hours, and he just really needs his jackets to be washed, so I had to wash it on Saturday. Then I put a glitter header, which I decided to remove, and put a full box there instead because I didn't want the full box right next to each other. As you know, I want them staggered, and then I put the glitter header after the full box. Then you'll see that I put my, I put a appointment label there with a car icon that I eventually moved down. And then instead of doing that one, I used a quarter box from Sponsored by Coffee and put a car icon because my mom needed her car to be boosted. She hasn't unused her car for over a month because of the snow and things like that. So we had to go help her boost her car, but eventually her car actually died. So we had to call BCA to get it towed to her mechanic. So in between doing all that stuff, we went to the grocery store because we need to get groceries and run a few errands, and the BCA would take a while to get to my mom and to tow her car anyways, to tow it to her mechanic. And I just put that other appointment label there just to mark that I've uploaded a video. And at the bottom, the quarter label, I'm going to put that I played magic with my hubby that night. And of course, my meal sticker on the very bottom. Next day, a glitter header. And then I put a quarter label from Sponsored by Coffee and an Instagram camera from Station Stickers just to mark that I was posting my hashtag before the pen for the next day. Or next week, I mean. And then I put a quarter label from KPL Plans, the music note one, because my hubby is operating soundboard at the church. Of course, followed by a full box. And of course, I'm going to put my flag with my church sticker. And my church sticker is always from Sponsored by Coffee. Next, here I'm putting my Sunday school sticker from KPL Plans because I was helping on the children's program that day. And after church, my hubby had a meeting, so I used a quarter label from Sponsored by Coffee with a heart icon to mark that he had a meeting at church after church. So I'm putting that glitter header just to separate all that church stuff. And while he was in the meeting, I went to Safeway to buy some more groceries because we were going to make lasagna. Well, he wanted to make lasagna and we didn't have ricotta cheese. So I just went there and just got a few items from the store. And on the bottom, I was trying to figure out where to put my movie marquee because we did watch the movie A Monster Calls. It's a really good movie. It's like a drama and fantasy. Definitely go check it out. It's about a little boy. I don't want to give it away too much. So I'm just trying to figure out where I am able to fit that and also fit the game night sticker from Planning Roses there because we did play Smash Up that night. And on the bottom, I finished it off with a weekend banner because I had no other space to put it. So this is my final spread. This is the next day, and I actually went and filled everything out, and I also added these birthday countdowns up here that kind of match the spread this week, and those are from Hello Petite Paper, and that's about the only changes I did, and I also went and filmed my voiceover, and sorry if my voice in my voiceover doesn't sound that great. Hubby does have a cold, and I'm hoping, knock on wood, that or laminate flooring here, that he hasn't transferred over to me. And also, I don't have really good microphone equipment. I'm just voiceovering on my laptop. But yeah, this is what it turned out, and I really, really like it, so I hope you do too. I'm going to try once more next week to do in my memory keeping planner, to do the plan as I go style. I like this look. So if you do like this look, definitely give me a thumbs up. And definitely don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I post 3 times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And until I see you next time, stay organized.